Okay, so good afternoon students, and welcome to the another lecture for this hydraulics and pneumatics. In last lecture we have discussed about the types of the compressors and its principle of working and the construction details. Okay, so we have discussed all these things regarding the compressors. Now in today's lecture we will discuss about the comparisons of pneumatic and with the hydraulic power transmission. So that is just the difference between these two, and we will discuss about some of the points from the next section, that is the types of filters, regulators. We will discuss the lubricators and mufflers. Okay, then directly we will discuss the quick exhaust valve and the time delay valve. Okay, the remaining the dryers, directional control valve, pneumatic actuator, shuttle valves and two pressure valve, we will come up in the next lecture. Okay, the other sections also. Okay, so the remaining sections here. So in today's lecture we will discuss just the comparisons and some of the points from the second section. Okay, so here now, so this is just the comparison. So we have already discussed in the previous lectures also, that is in the unit number 1, regarding the hydraulic systems and the pneumatic system. So these are the things that differentiate between the two systems. Okay, so we have already discussed in hydraulic system, so it employs a pressurized liquid. Okay, so here the oil comes as a working fluid, while in case of the pneumatic system, so it is a compressed gas, so it may be either generally it is a air. Okay, so that's why this is the pneumatic system. Now the pressure range in these systems, it ranges up to the 700 bar, while in the pneumatic system it usually operates in between the 5 to 10 bar. Okay, now this is a closed system. Hydraulic system is a closed system and the pneumatic system is an open system. So we'll see how this system becomes here the open system, because at the end of the that means in when we are designing the pneumatic system, so the working fluid which is we are using, that is air, so it is then dispersed to the environment. Okay, so that's why it is the open system. Wherever in case of the hydraulic systems, everything, all the connections are closed, and the oil depressurized the oil, whenever we supply that pressurized fluid, that is oil, through the system, hydraulic system, so it again comes back to the reservoir. Okay, so here that type of the system is not there. Okay, so the pressurized air, that it leaves the system, so that's why it is called we are calling that as the open system. Okay, now here the system slows down when leakage occurs. So that is the problem here in hydraulic system. Leakage is not that much affect the pneumatic systems. Okay, now valves operations are difficult here in case of the hydraulic systems, where that is not the case in case of the pneumatic systems. Generally this is lighter in weight, the pneumatic systems are lighter in weight. Now pumps are used to provide the pressurized liquids. So we have discussed about the different types of the pumps in the hydraulic systems. Here in pneumatic system, to pressurize, to get the pressurized air, we have to use the compressor. Okay, now this system is unsafe, and the unsafe to fire hazards, since we are using that oil here. Now because of that, the air, this system is free from the fire hazards. Now automatic lubrication is provided here. Now special arrangement for lubrications are needed here. So we'll discuss about why the lubrication is needed in case of the pneumatic systems also. Okay, so this is general the descriptions regarding the hydraulic and the pneumatic system. Now we'll directly go to the types of the filter. Now the next topic, there is the filters. Here we are discussing about the pneumatic filter. Now what is this pneumatic filter is? So it is a system, the component that can prevent premature failure of your pneumatic machinery. And this is a device designed to remove the contaminant from a compressed air stream. So same type of the filters we also discuss in the hydraulic systems, which removes the contaminants from the oil. Okay, and the same type of the filter that is used also in the pneumatic systems. Okay, so that is used to remove the contaminants from the compressed air stream. Okay, which is coming from the compressor. Okay, now here there are different types of the pneumatic filters are there. One is called the water separators. Now water separators, so this is the type, one of the type of the water separator is there. Here the water or the moisture. Okay, so that is removed from the compressed air, because if they are present in the inside this in the pneumatic system, so they causes they cause deterioration and stick to the systems, and because of that they reduce the effectiveness of the product, or the there may be the decrease in the effectiveness of the system. Okay, so to remove this the water or the moisture, what we have to use, we are using here the water separators. Okay, so this water separators, it separates the water and the moisture from the compressed air, and help to remove the water or the waterborne contaminants. Okay, so this is the first type of the filter that is used in the pneumatic system. So that is what are the water pneumatic water separators. Now this is the animations regarding the working of this the filters. Now if you see here, so dirty air enters the filter through the directional louvers, which force it into a whirling flow pattern. So this air is coming with the moisture or the air. So when it whenever there is when it revolves, okay, that means whenever it causes the turbulence, what will happen, that water it is separated. So that is the second part. Liquid particles and heavy solids are thrown against the inside wall, and whatever that water is there, so that is collected at the bottom of the bowl. So here, this is, if you see here, this is the water content, water droplets are there, which get removed. Now as the liquid builds up, the float rises, causing the drain, and so because of that pressure, what will happen, this moves up and the water gets removed from the system, and whatever the which air is there, so that air, the compressed air, without that moisture, it passes through it, it exits from the separator through this exhaust valve. Okay, so this is the entry of the air with moisture. Here it the moisture get removed, so it comes down, it leaves the wall here, and because of that the moisture get removed from the wall here. Okay, so here there is a removal of the moisture, and whatever the compressed air is there without moisture, so that is the air, then it passes through the pass through this outlet through the pneumatic system. Okay, so this is one type of the filter is there, so that is related with the water separator. Okay, now the other filters are this is the particulate filters. Now the particulate filters, so what will happen if the particles are there, if presence inside the pneumatic system, so we know that if particles are there, they causes they causes the wear and tear. Okay, so they are often generated from the old carbon steel pipes and desiccant air drives. So because of that, these components, the particles that enters into the system, so we have to go for these particulate filters, which allows a large surface area in order to work efficiently when trapping dirt and the dust, trapping dirt and the dust particles. Okay, because these dirt and the dust particles, they causes what, the wear and tear of the systems. So for that purpose, we have to go for the particulate filters. So that is the second type of the filter that is used in the pneumatic system. That is called the pneumatic particulate filters. Okay, so this is the pictures of that filters which is used in the industry. The third type of the pneumatic filter is the pneumatic coalescing filter. Okay, so these filters are used for again the removing the water, oil, and the rust from the air supply. Okay, so if you are going for this type of the third type of the filter, that is coalescing filter, so they are used for removing the moisture, water, and the oil and the rust from the air supply. Okay, and it works as the air moves through the filter element, solid particles, traps, and liquids are formed into droplets that drain away. So that is the same type of the working principle is there as that of the water filter. But this is particularly used for water only, or to remove the water and moisture, while the coalescing filter, these are used for removing the water, oil, and the rust. Okay, so it also performs the function of the particulate filter also. So this is the combinations of water and the particulate filter. Okay, so that is the third type of the filter is there. The last type of filter is the adsorbing filter. So as the name suggests, what is meant by this adsorbing? So this is used to remove the oil from the compressed air stream. Okay, So this is used to, particularly this is used to trap these the oil, okay, or to absorb the oil, okay. So they are used to they are used for the breathing air preparation and food and drug applications, okay. So these are the applications of this adsorbing filters, okay. Now this is the particular the symbols for the this is used for the filters, okay. So we will use this filter this type of the symbol when we'll develop the pneumatic system. So this filter may be of any four types, okay. So that is now how will when we are going for purchasing the filter. So its filtering capacity is determined by the minimum impurities that can be removed by the filter element. So how much, that is the minimum size of the solid particle it can remove. So based on that, its capacity can be decided, and also the moisture separating coefficient, because we have seen most of the filter they are used for removing the moisture and the particles, okay. So its capacity, it is determined by means of the minimum size of the solid particles that can be removed and the moisture separating coefficient. So here this is the one type of the general parameters are given for the pneumatic filters. So this is 5 the nanometer or greater in filtering capacity. So this is for 5 the micrometer, and then 0.8 micrometer for the in moisture separating coefficient. Okay, so these two the values are given for deciding the filtering capacity or for the pneumatic filters, okay. And these symbols you have to remember. So this is the symbol for the filters. So this is all the discussion regarding the filters there, okay. So the filters, okay, so this is the basic function of the filter, to remove moisture and the dust particles, okay. And these are the types of the filters are there. Now the next comes the pneumatic pressure regulator. So as the name suggests, this is used for regulating the pressure, okay. So air pressure, it is regulated using this pressure regulator. So this is just similar to the pressure relief valve as we are using in the hydraulic system, okay. So what is its function? Its main function is to control the pressure with close tolerances to ensure that compressed air in a pneumatic system is not wasted, okay. So this, for that purpose, this pressure regulator, it is used. Now these are generally used for the various home, medical and industrial application, such as home furnaces, tanks for oxygen, okay, and anesthesia gases and pneumatic automation system. So for that purpose, this pneumatic pressure regulators are used, okay. This type of the systems we are generally seeing when we fill the air in our vehicle also, that type of the air regulators are available there, okay. So that is our pressure regulators are there, okay. So this is the schematic for the pressure regulator. Let me show you how this system works, okay. So we have one small video regarding that one.
This is how fast YouTube is with brain. Notice how there's no pre-roll ad.
Aircom Pneumatic, the specialist for pressure and volume flow control.
Okay. So
function of a pressure regulator. On the left side, shown here in dark blue.
Okay, so if you see here, this is the pressure regulator one is there, and here we have the spring arrangement. We can operate that spring using this lever. So when we are operating that one, so that the pressurized air, it is flowing, and that we can monitor using this pressure gauge, okay. Here okay, so this is there. So whenever that when we are pressing it, okay, what will happen, this get pressurized, and there is opening for the air, okay. So it is going outside. At the same time, there is one diaphragm is also there at the other another end on the top of this one, okay. So when if the pressure is that means when we have to release the pressure, okay, so we can operate the diaphragm also. So if excess air is there, so that is also removed using the through this outlet. So this is the discharge air now, okay. So that means if this air, okay, if you see carefully here,
So this air, it is now, it is directly going to the environment. Okay, so we are discharging this to the environment. Okay, so these are no use to us now. Okay, so that means by releasing air to the environment, so we are releasing the pressure of the decreasing the pressure of the air. The another is the okay, so this is that one. Another one is this is this part. This part it is going to the pneumatic system. Okay, so from here, if you see, there is another vent is also there. So that is this vent. Okay, if you check this one here, so this part. So here we are regulating the again the second part. Okay, that means the some part of the pressurized the air it is removed through this outlet also to maintain the pressure of the incoming air. Okay, so this is the one part. Another part is through this outlet also. Okay, so in both way we can regulate the air. That means we can release the air and we can regulate the pressure. Okay, so that is the working of this pressure regulator, pneumatic pressure regulator. Okay, and this is now the manually operated using the lever. Okay, that is there. So this is the diaphragm which is available on the top. Okay, and there is also the vent there to release the pressurized fluid here, which is there in the center. Okay, so this part is there. So that is the same the function is there for the it is worked on the same principle of the pressure relief valve. Okay, so this is the schematic for that one, and this is the symbol for that air regulator. Okay. So this is our pressure gauge. This is the support part of the pressure gauge. This is the pilot valve. Now when we get, that means when we receive the that means the indication that the pressure is above the safe limit, so the valve gate opens. Okay, now this is the open valve. Okay, the valve gate opens and the air gate release. Okay, so this is the arrow is in the spring, so this is spring operated and arrow is there, so that is variable. That means we can set the pressure also here. Okay, so that is the symbol for the air regulator. Okay, so that is the second part, the filter. This is the second the type of the component for the pneumatic system, that is called the pneumatic pressure regulator. Okay, now the third component is the lubricators. Okay, now the same type, what is known as the lubricator. So for a lubricator for pneumatic system, it provides the lubrications to the internal working parts of the pneumatic tools and the components. The same type of function, so the lubrication, so that is for the pneumatic tools and the components. Now which components are included here in the pneumatic system? So it may be actuating cylinders, it may be valves and the motors. Motors we are using for running the compressors, valves for the maintaining the flow rate of the air inside the pneumatic system, and these are the actuating cylinders to get the motions. Now the device injects a stream of oil into the airline, ensuring they perform at the optimum level at all the times. Okay, so certain types of the stream of the oil is injected inside the pneumatic systems for the lubrication purpose. Now here this is the one type of the pneumatic lubricator which is used in the industry. Okay, now how it works, so here this is the working of this the pneumatic lubricator is mentioned here. Okay, so there is one container for the oil is there, and then through that it injects the oil to the pneumatic systems, and through which we can do the lubrications for the pneumatic tools and the components. Now the function of the lubricating systems, it is used for the lubricating, we have just discussed. These are the different parts are there, just go through the theory part here. I'm not going into details. Directly go to the types of the pneumatic lubricators. So there are three types of the pneumatic lubricators are there, which are generally used in the industry: side fit lubricators, weak fit lubricators, and the single pole lubricators. Okay, so this is regarding the pneumatic lubricators. Now this is again one of the interesting thing that is used in the pneumatic system, that is called the muffler. Again, the word muffler, we know what is meant by this muffler. We call this as a silencer, generally used in our bikes, okay, cars and other things in vehicles. So the main function of this muffler is to what? Is to reduce the sound level. Okay. So here in pneumatic system also, since we are using the air, so we know that whenever there air is there, so it generates the sound. Okay. So that sound it is reduced by means of the muffler. Okay. So we know here it is given. See, this is mufflers also part of the silencers. Safely and quietly vent pressurized air to the atmosphere. Now, what will happen when this the air is moving at very high speed? What will happen? It generates the turbulent, and this turbulent it generates the sound. Okay. So for that purpose, this muffler it is used. So this is the images for the pneumatic muffler. So that air is passed through these mufflers and to reduce the sound. Okay, so here without a muffler, air exhausting from many types of the pneumatic powered equipment can be so loud. So that is the disadvantage if you are not using any muffler, as to be detrimental to the surrounding environment and potentially harm workers. So if the air is passing through at very high speed, so it is generating the turbulent, and because of this turbulence, the sound of the air it increases, and that means irritate the workers which are operating the pneumatic system. So to reduce this sound in the total pneumatic systems, we have to go for the pneumatic mufflers. Okay, so for that purpose, these mufflers are used. Now again, the same thing, all the descriptions are given here, how we can reduce the sound. So this silencer can reduce the noise from the pneumatic system by 15 to 35 decibel. Okay, so and these are generally made up of the plastic or the metal, like brass and the stainless steel. Okay, applications we have just discussed. So the common application is just to reduce the sound, and here there is a range it is given. So it reduces the sound from by 15 to 35 decibels. Okay, so that is for the regarding the mufflers. Okay. So and now the last two the terms that is related to the pneumatic systems are the quick exhaust valve. Now you know the term itself, it indicate what is the functionality of this exhaust valve. So what is meant by this is quick exhaust valve means what? We have to remove that pressurized air quickly from our the pneumatic system. So for that purpose, the quick exhaust valve it is used. Actually, it is a 3x2 way valve. That means three. So this is three means here this is A. This is the three ports A. This is the pressure port P and E. And this is two position. So this is two means for this is position. So three ports A, pressure port P. Then this is for the cylinder actuating cylinder, and then E is for the exhaust, and two is for the position. So this is here the flexible ring is there. So this is the position one, and this is the second position. So left and right, there are two positions for this flexible ring. Okay, and so what will happen now? See, in initial conditions, the pressurized fluid, the air, it is going from pressure port to the A port, that is to the cylinder, and pneumatic system is working. We have not supplied any the air to the exhaust port. Okay, so that is the initial working of the quick exhaust valve. Okay, so this is there. Now initially this exhaust valve is closed. Now we required that all the we don't require don't want to supply the air, that means we don't require any air from the pressurized the air from the pressure port, and whatever the air which are coming from the actuator, so that directly to be exhausted. So it is coming from the cylinder and it is going to the exhaust. Okay, so we will see this one also. We will connect the exhaust. There is one the exhaust term is there in the that the software. Okay, so let me show you if it is possible to show you that. There is exhaust that symbol is there for the exhaust, and then that we have to connect it to the system, and through that whatever the during so whatever that the fluid which is coming from that cylinder during the retraction, okay, so that total fluid, okay, so that is total fluid, that is air, that is the air, so it goes to the exhaust. Okay, it goes to the environment. Okay, So let me show you whether it is now it is available. And we will see, we will design all these circuits, that is pneumatic circuits, on this Automation Studio. Okay, so everything will be clear to you. Okay, so this is the professional software that is used for the for developing the hydraulic and the pneumatic circuits. Okay, so that is all, that is part of the Automation Studio. Just a minute. Okay. So here, let me. Okay. So we are discussing about this exhaust. So let me show you now. Yeah, so this is that software. Here we have hydraulics and pneumatics. Okay, now if you see here, if you see here, here there is one symbol. Okay, so I think this is visible to you. See, this is the that symbol is there, exhaust. Here this that symbol, exhaust. Okay, see, this is that symbol, that is the exhaust. Okay, that means see, this is our this is the cylinder. Okay, this is the rubber acting cylinder. Now, suppose if we are supplying the fluid from here, this piston is going, moving from left to right, and then whatever the air, whatever the air which is there on this side, so we will connect this exhaust to this the output end. So if you check here, see this one. See, this is aim is what? This aim is here. This is A. Okay. And what is this E? Exhaust. Now this is the E. So this is denoted by the E. This is E is there. Okay, and what is this? This one, this part, this part. This is the this is P. This is P to A. Okay, this is P to A. This is going from P to A. So here we'll attach the pressure. So this is the here this is the compressor. Okay, so we have to attach that compressor here. We have to attach that compressor here. We'll attach that compressor, so it will go to the it will supply the pressurized fluid here. Okay. So that is for that one. So this is the exhaust. Now, if you see here, this is the symbol for that exhaust. Okay. So exhaust means here there is our exhaust valve. Okay. So this is the exhaust. So we are directly removing the air from the actuating cylinder directly to the exhaust. Okay. Using the flexible ring. So what is this? This is actually, it is a 3x2 wave valve. How we'll define this 3? 3 means it is pressure port. This is actuating port. Okay, port A is go to the actuator. And then this is the exhaust port. So 3 is for P, A and E. What is this 2 is for? 2 is for the flexible ring position. This is first position where the pressurized air, it is going from the P to A. And in second position, the fluid is going from A to E. Okay, so that is the second position. So this is the second position. Okay, so this is the description regarding the quick exhaust valve. Okay, so we can quickly remove, or we can directly go to the exhaust. Okay, so from the cylinder. Now the last topic from the today's lecture, it is the time delay valve. Now the again the title itself, it says the time delay valve. That means we have to operate, if you are doing certain operations. Okay, so that means there must be certain delay, time delay. There must be some time delay there. Okay, so for that purpose we are requiring here some time delay valve. So here we can explain it something like this. So suppose we have the punch, and here the workpiece is there. Okay, now what will happen? We required here time delay of suppose the 30 seconds. Okay, that means when the punch comes on the top side, so it must remain here the up to 30 seconds, so that we can put the workpiece here. We can put the workpiece here. After that, what will happen? That punch will come. It will press the workpiece. Okay, it will press the workpiece here. Okay, so it will press the workpiece when it comes downward. Now, when it press the, so it must remain here for the 20 seconds, and then it will go up. That means to remove the workpiece and to place the new workpiece here, we required here that the upper part should remain up to 30 seconds. And when it comes downward and when it press the workpiece, so it must remain here for 20 seconds. Okay, so that contact should remain for the 20 seconds, and then it will go up. After 20 seconds, it will go up. So then we will remove our workpiece here. Okay, so how we'll achieve this the time part? Okay, so 30 seconds and this 20 seconds. So that two things that is achieved by means of this the time delay valve. So here there is a check valve. Here we have the ori piece. So this is our ori piece here. This is the ori piece. This is non-return valve. The flow is possible from this direction and not from this direction. So whenever there is a the flow from Z to this to the directional control valve, so it is through this the ori piece. And here we can regulate the flow rate so that we can get here the time delay. Okay, so we will set that timing using this ori piece. Okay, so the 30 second, 20 second, that timing can be set using this. Or we are calling that metering. Okay, metering. So that is through the ori piece. Okay, so that is possible. So this is the same valve. It is schematically shown here, where we have the needle. That is the needle valve. So that is time set screw. We are calling this as a time set screw, where using this we can set the time. This is the time here. Okay, so that's why this is called the time set screw. So by operating this time set screw, we can set a time. Okay, this is the needle valve. Here we have the reservoir. Then here we have the piston. These are the three ports: pressure, exhaust, and this A will go to the actuator. Okay, it will go to the cylinder. Now, if you check here, this is Z. This is the Z, the flow rate which is coming from Z, and this is the signal for the A, that is the actuator. Now, if we check here using this the time delay valve, see there is some space is there between the start of the signal from Z to A. So signal is that means the pressurized fluid is coming from here, but whenever it comes up to A, okay, it goes from Z, but whenever it comes to A, that to cylinder, there is a time delay of T. There is a time delay of T, and this is set by means of this time set screw. Okay, so I have explained to you that using this the example. Okay, so I require here time delay of 30 seconds so that I can place the new workpiece and I can remove the punch workpiece. Okay, here after punching, so it must be there for 20 seconds and then it must go up. Okay, so this type of the things we can set up using the time delay valve. Okay, so this is the working for the time delay valve. So this is the symbol for the time delay valve, and this is the schematic for the time delay valve. Okay, so I think this is the concepts are clear to you regarding the time delay valve from the today's lecture. So quick exhaust valve, just to remove everything from actuators to the environment. So I have shown you that the example that the symbol for that one also. Pneumatic muffler, that is used for reducing the sound which is generated in the pneumatic system. Okay, lubricators are used for supplying the oil to the components and the tools from the pneumatic system. Pressure regulators, they perform the functions of the pressure relief valve. Okay, and these are used for the safely operating the pneumatic system. Okay, so that is for the pressure regulators. Filters we have designed discussed. They remove the moisture and the dirt. Okay, or the dirt, or the dust and dust particles from the system. There are four types of the filters we have discussed. Okay, and then at the start of the lecture we have discussed about the hydraulic system and the pneumatic systems. Okay, so comparison between these two. Okay, so this is all regarding from the today's lectures. So we have covered now up to last week we have covered this part. Today we have covered the comparison. We have discussed about the filters, we have discussed about the filter regulators, lubricators, then mufflers, and then directly we have shifted to the quick exhaust valve and the time delay valves. Okay, so this much part we have covered in the today's lecture. In tomorrow's lectures we will start from the dryers, then directional control valves, pneumatic actuator, shuttle valve, two pressure valve, and then we'll discuss the circuits here, pneumatic circuits here. Okay, and finally we'll discuss the applications of this in low cost automation and industrial automation. Okay, so this is all regarding the today's lectures. If any question is there regarding any content from the today's lecture, you can ask. Otherwise, you just put your roll numbers in the chat box. We'll consider that as your attendance. Okay, so then for today's lecture, we'll stop here. Thank you.